Good evening, everybody on YouTube. Hope you guys are all doing great. So we are here at the SD dealership over here in Bangalore. This is located near Ragi Gudda Temple on near JP Nagar. So you can visit the showroom. They are extremely good, and the entire staff and everyone. So we are here to look at the new Road King Adventure from SD. First impressions? No, it is not a replica of the Himalayan. This is far different than what the Himalayan is. Of course, yeah, they have the same wheel size. So this one is running on the same 21 inch front and 18 inch rear. The tires are exactly the same. So, and the suspension travel is nearly the same. But then the way they have designed the entire front of this motorcycle, if you look at it closely, it looks exceptionally beautiful. I mean, this is way, way better looking than what the Himalayan is, at least from the front. Now let's go through all the details one by one. So up front, basically what the good folks at Classic Legends have done is they have picked up every single point that the Himalayan was missing and they have improved on it. So to begin with, it gets this beautiful looking LED setup. The headlight is LED, the blinker is LED, and the tail lamp is LED as well. Moving on to the side, here is the main heart of the matter, that is the engine. So this is again derived from the Perax engine, so this makes significantly more power than the Himalayan. While the Himalayan makes about like 24 bhp, this makes approximately 30.6 bhp. So you have approximately 6 bhps more, and this is a 6-speed gearbox. This is a dual overhead cam liquid cool engine. There you can see the radiator over here. While the Himalayan is a normal air-cooled engine, this gets liquid cooling. And the ground clearance is nearly the same at 220 mm. But the most important point about the SD Road King is that this is approximately 10 kilos lighter than the Himalayan. Yeah, you heard it right. While the Himalayan is nearly 194 kilos, this thing is approximately 184. So 10 kgs of difference makes, 10 kgs of weight difference. It's a big thing, you know, especially when you're there on the off-road. This makes a huge difference. And of course, as industry standards, you get dual disc 300 mm at the front, 200 change at the rear. I'm not really sure. You can see the numbers on the screen right now. Dual channel ABS, and this thing comes with three different ride modes, which will eventually control the way your ABS responds. So you get the urban, you get a trail, and you get a city, I suppose. So in trail or terrain, the rear ABS would be turned off, so you can actually slide the rear completely. And yeah, it gets this big bulky seat, and the seats are pretty comfortable. You know, the fabric is pretty decent. Your rider will not be slipping all over, and this is very well cushioned, very well padded for both rider and the pillion. And the swing arm, again similar to Himalayan, it has a linked unit, and because of the way the swing arm the rear suspension is designed, there is no provision to fit a center stand on this thing. So that's one bummer, but then I believe, yeah, that can be taken care of, I suppose. And I absolutely love the fact that the SD engineers have, you know, taken forward the entire old design. See these stripes on the fuel tank? The same thing goes over here and on this part as well, and until the side panels. So this was something that was existing in the old model of SD Road King, and they have beautifully carried it whole. Now from the rider's perspective, as you can see, the seats are pretty low. They're not as low as Himalayan, but then for my height, I'm 5'8" for a reference with a 32 inch inseam. I can keep both the feet on the ground. I cannot flat foot. I can flat foot only one side, but the other side would be on toes. And I love the way they have designed this thing. This is incredible. You know, this is like a proper Dakar kind of a design. So you have this, I'm sorry, the battery disconnected, hence I cannot show you all the details. So here you have all the telltale lights. This is where you have the speedometer, your rev counter and everything else. This is where you will paired with your phone for turn button navigation, and some more information will come up over here. This is a nifty handy little USB socket. So you get a USB and you get a type C as well, both support fast charging. And yeah, these buttons, they will help you navigate through the menu. So you have a menu, you have a set of top and down navigation, up and down, and you have the light controls over here, the horn over this side. And yeah, this button quality, you know, the quality of switch gear that they have used, it's incredible. It's really, really it's better than what you would get on a Himalayan for sure. And yeah, the seat posture is pretty good. So right now we don't have the motorcycle available for us, right, because it's going to be available from next week sometime. So stay tuned to the channel. We'll anyways bring the complete detailed ride review of this product. But overall, man, I'm in love with this motorcycle, especially from the way it looks from the front. You see, it has a proper big bike feeling to it. If you ask me about something that I do not like is the design of the exhaust. Somehow I think this is little too bulky, you know, it looks too bulky. I do not know how much does it weigh, and there are certain things which they could have concentrated on finishing it better, like these weld marks. You see these small bubbles have popped up over here. This is again bad quality welding. It's not properly finished, right? So the weld marks can be seen here, and it's rough. It is pretty rough. While you are cleaning your motorcycle, you should be a little careful. This can actually scratch your hands. That's one thing which I am not a big fan of on this entire motorcycle, the way it is designed. But yeah, stay tuned, stay subscribed to the channel, and we'll get you the detailed ride review very soon. I hope that you guys like this video. In case if you did, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends and acquaintances, and I'll see you guys again. There it is, the legendary ESD Road King. Bye bye.